And of course, there goes the idiot.
Oh. Kindly ignore, pretty much everything. Not bad. Sorry for being so late. We forgot to get some of our food out. And ready, so. Yeah. Off screen, I did a little more playing on Monday. I finished off the Big Weasel Little Weasel quest. I figured out something about Cherubie. Cherubie comes out more frequently in the next area we're going to be going to after finishing this. I still have to finish the Roselia one. I did get this one as well. I don't want to do that right now, though. I also got Togepi to evolve. So it's a Togetic now. I'm going to finish off its, I'm gonna finish off its page in the Pokédex before I evolve it into Togekiss. Figure three times with Air Slash, and then we can evolve it. And we'll be good. I did catch some more stuff and released it, so I have a bit more money now. Not a ton, but still. Either way, we are actually gonna So the last two Pokemon that I want in my party are in the very last area. I didn't realize she was out during the day. I thought Vessa would only come out at night. Something wrong with Boomer right now because he is constantly ringing the bell and we don't know why. Also, I did lose one of my charms. I got hit with a stun spore. Or it was either that or it was a thunder wave, one of the two. So I gotta go get a new one. So you may notice also the shrine rock looks very, very much like something. What color did I get this time? Purple again. Now we are going to actually complete properly the Lordless Island. I don't want to do that yet. Boing. I just love how it automatically changes you. there's a glitch, she sounded cool. Coming over here again because I want to try and catch your Basculin. Scared them both. There are other places to catch them. But as you can tell, they are very skittish. Maybe getting off the water, being on the land will help. The reason I'm not trying to catch any of the Mothin is because I don't know if I have a male Burmy, and if I do, I don't want to catch one now. I'm just doing this to get a little bit more EXP on Vaporeon. Because if I remember this fight correctly, this one was hard. Like, the Pokemon I had for it was bad. I don't know which sister I'm going to be fighting this time. I don't know if it's going to be Charm or Clover. I don't think it's Coin again. Still no Magby. I did, however, catch a Pichu. And this is the other reason why this fight sucks. Okay, so it's Clover. And even more evidence is, if we needed it, that Clover is Candace's ancestor. She's using Candace's ace. Because I am strong. fight both of these two. Attention and switching them out. This is gonna end badly for Togekiss, but really it's the only Pokemon I have that's good. Now, Charm is the only one with two Pokemon. Rhydon. This is not the Pokemon that should be going out right now because it will get its butt kicked. You know what? This is a dumb idea, but I'm gonna do it anyway. Only because I need a turn to do this. Yeah, I had a feeling that was gonna happen. Oh well. So she has a ride on. So a ground type, and now she has a Gengar, ghost type. Again, Charm is the ancestor of both Bertha and Agatha. If you hear that very loud clicking in the background, that is my dad trying to figure out what the hell is going on with our tree lights. And I apologize if it is obnoxious as hell, because it is. Evolving. Say hello to Hisuian Arcanine. Space-time rift is opening. And here comes the lightning. And now, Arcanine is frenzied. got a point. Yes. So, first things first. Probably do this. And also, more importantly, I should heal up Vaporeon. I'm going to need Vaporeon for this next part. Also, I did get another star. This fight sucks. Because of the lava. Guess what? It hurts like heck if you land in that. Oh, close. When those lights come up, you have to basically throw the bombs as fast as you can to get rid of them. Other part of this one that's a problem is the fact that Arcanine literally just cut my movement by a lip ton. So now I cannot get across there. Easily kill me. Ow. Oh, of course I can't reach that far. Yeah, I'm so dead right now. Oh my god! If that last hit had hit. If he had gotten to hit me at that point, I would have lost. Holy crap! Well, he baby now. Yeah, exactly. Holy shit. Up there. And it's gone. The late Lord's spirit was up there. She is very young. I think Iridia and Admin are only like in their 20s. We can just warp here at any time. You don't get much from a one Pokemon catch. Not much there either. Jesus. I'm still like, holy shit. Wrong button. The next lord is also super obnoxious. This next one is one that I've had to restart. I had to restart on a lot before I figured out that I don't have to restart. But now, after this, look at Benny, he's old. This is the reason, this part is the reason why I didn't want to just do Fire Spit right away. Good morning, good lady who came from the sky. Commander Kamado told me to let you know he awaits your arrival in his office. He's got quite tatters, doesn't he? Electrode is mean. Admin's just like, great. This is probably my least favorite character in this entire game. Melly is the warden for Electrode. Oh no! Melly is kind of childish. And he's very ridiculous. And also a dick. He's not even looking. So Adamon uses a Leafeon primarily, and he also has a regular Eevee. So, interestingly enough... Oh! Yeah! By the way, yeah, exactly! That's exactly how Melly is! Anyway, what I was saying, Adamon and Iridia both use evolutions that were introduced in Gen 4. No problem, Adamon. Adamon's gonna give him hell. Oh, heck. Hi, Captain. Head to Jubilee Village Train Grounds to meet Ingo of the Pearl Clan. Seems familiar. But before we do that, I have some quests to get. So I have to get a worm in him. First, oh, I want to see if the Burmy quest is out. Yes, the Burmy quest is ready. Good. We need to catch a Mistrevious. There are reasons for Taohua. They're not good reasons. They're very dumb reasons. For sure, if I do. I do have Ghastly's complete. Your son will. We got another linking cord, which will be useful for when we actually, when I actually have to evolve that Ghastly into a Gengar. Anyway, we're gonna go over to the farm real quick. Cause, nope, it is not. Do I have a Rock Smash Pokemon? Really. Ugh, my Croagunk or my Machop. Damn it. I need both of those. You know what? I can catch another Machop later. Probably at a better level, too. So now we got the final upgrade to the fields. Go over there, but I don't want to just yet. There are some more requests in the hall. Oh, also, yeah, I don't know if that happened on stream, but his Pokemon evolved again. I'm gonna get one more upgrade for this. I hate space limitations. Aha! So that's out already, is it? He's gonna... A princely Pokemon. the other big reason why I wanted to do Legends right away after doing Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl. Now I need to remember which Pokemon I need. And a quillfish with big spines, which I can do. It's just gonna be a pain in the butt to do. So it means I have to take three Pokemon out of my team. I mean, obviously I can take these two out, but I have one other one. Oh, I also caught an Alpha Rapidash. Let's see, I don't have another Buizel that I, oh, yes I do, never mind, there it is. I need a Buizel, a Mantyke. Take Cinderel because I'm going to be facing water types and it will not be useful. So the problem is the quillfish. I do not have a quillfish with big spikes. Times and strong style. So be doing something a little stupid right now. Oh. Never mind, we gotta go fill this out. We gotta do this part first. Which is probably, I should actually go fix my team again real quick. Should at least grab Cinder back. My Weasel is gonna go crazy levels right now. I'm gonna take Mantyke out because if I can make an excuse to use Quillfish, I can't, I will. But now we're gonna go over and we're gonna meet Iridia and her, and the warden from the Pro Clan, who is the guy who greeted us this morning. Sneasler. This guy makes me sad. That pose. Post kind of special. And the all aboard. Ingo is a bit like you. He appeared one day from who knows where. What's more, much of his memory seems to be missing. I was going to be battling. I forgot that we don't battle him right away. I'll get more into Ingo later when we've talked to him more. anyone who knows while watching, please do not spoil it in the comments. Or in the chat, rather. So, we're supposed to... Wow, I didn't realize my cursor was all the way over there. We're supposed to go here. We're actually gonna go to the field lens. I'm gonna do some battling. I need to get this quillfish taken care of. I think my dad's trying to get Boomer to get on the couch with him. If you hit a Pokemon with a Pokeball that has a Pokemon in it, they will catch them unawares and they will be dizzy. Which is good if you're trying to battle a lot. Of course, honestly, taking on, instead of Bidoof, going after some Shinx is probably a better idea. Because Shinx are going to always be hostile. So, let's get some attention. Another thing for happiness evolutions, I'm going to bring this up now while I'm thinking, since I just saw the tumblestones in the back. Using them to knock stuff out of trees and break the tumblestones, so you can get the tumblestones out. Is also good for that. Oh yeah, it's probably in the Obsidian Field lens, actually, because of it being found here. Yep. I'm at 4, and I need to hit 20. I've already pretty much finished off its dex. I'm at 3. I'm at 5. Anything with the red arrows is worth 2. So... have 3 checks here, but it's 5 research level. I evolved 2 Magikarp, so. I didn't even notice the difference. Male Gyarados have blue whiskers and females have white. I didn't notice that at first. Ground is glitching the heck right now. Jeez. Nope, it's still twitchy. Healed off. a weasel. There's one. So, one interesting thing about the strong style and agile style, if a move has an odd number of power points or PP, you can still strong style or agile style if you only have one left. Heal now. I didn't realize we were going to get the Seize Legend right away. Otherwise, I would have probably been better prepared for this. But at least I get to show this off on screen. So, normally, Quillfish is a water poison. In this game, it is a dark poison type. Reason I'm fighting Shinx and the like is because they are aggressive Pokemon, so they will not run off. I found a Pichu over here on Monday when I was kind of just grinding off screen. Oops. I forgot to hit the right button. I missed the button. Oh well. Oh, it raining. I'm technically just at 10 right now. Go. This was a bad idea. Glad I realized that before it was too late. Shinx in this area. over this way, though. There is the Alpha Snorlax over there that I still can't handle. I very nearly got my butt beat by again. This is not worth it for EXP. Seven more. But it is worth it for what I have to do. It's a lot quicker than trying to go and fight multiple Pokemon. Or a lot stronger Pokemon and risking getting Quillfish knocked out. Those. Six more. Okay. I just gotta go find six Geodudes to fight. And that's easy enough. They're gonna be over this way. Hello, Geodude. It's not going to be super effective, but it's level 8 versus level 32. At least half. So, I only really need to fight two more Geodudes. Here they are. Just get back a little bit so I don't get wrecked. This one might take more hits, which is fine. Maybe not. And it got poisoned on top of that. In Gold and Silver and Crystal, Quillfish could not evolve. But here in Hisui, Overquill. This is the Quillfish with big spikes. Catch anything, so we're able to just go. Oh, I did catch something. What the fuck did I catch? Oh, no, I have to. Right. I have to turn in Quillfish's stuff. Coastlands, and we will mass outbreaks are when obviously a large amount of Pokemon show up. I had one happen while I was off screen. It was a Piplup, and I managed to catch a few. So, all right, here we are. Now, go through here. Feel. Need to go back behind here. Switch to Luxray. Here somewhere. Nope, that's not it. That's the tidal passage. I thought it was on this side. Maybe I'm wrong, it's on the other side. It is the Prince of the Sea, Manaphy, and three Fionn. Oh, right. Gotta hit him first. I need to at least catch one of each one of these and the Manaphy. I'm gonna try a Pokeball, even though the Great Ball didn't hold very well. I have more Pokeballs. Although what I really should be using is probably one of my feather balls, because I have like so many of these damn things. Luxray. Good thing is, I believe Fionn only has water type attacks. Which will not do it any good against Vaporeon. Nope. Because Vaporeon is also a water type. This defense raised so much, I might be able to do an attack. That's better. I mean, I shouldn't expect much. Oh, uh-oh. That's not good. I am very poorly prepared for this. Thank you, Jesus Christ. I don't know. I can probably leave, I think I have actually exited briefly to grab some more stuff, but... Alright. I don't want the Fionn. I need... Manaphy. Problem, of course, is if you attack Manaphy, then you get the Fionn to show to come in as well. I might come back later. The only reason I made it on this one the first time I did this was because I was using an Umbreon, because I had an Umbreon on my team, and that's because Umbreon is special defense tank. smart option would have been for me just to catch the Fionn. And then come back for Manaphy. But change my team up because we're going into the coast. We're gonna go into the Coronet Highlands now. Don't really need these three anymore. So I think we can just get there now. That's not where I wanted that. Cinder back. And we'll grab this Ponyta because I still need to evolve it. And you know, we'll take Vasculin because I need to. I'm gonna go talk to Ginter, see if he's got anything interesting. Nothing useful there. Next star, I believe, is me being able to finally get Ultra Balls. So now, we're gonna go into Coronet Highlands. And we're gonna get our fourth ride Pokemon. Which, in case it's not obvious, is Sneasler. Now, this is the better place to find Cherubee. This is Mount Coronet. So that's that was a little hint towards something else we can do with our Saluna that we'll talk about later. The Fable. And Probopass. Is Moon. Moon is probably right above my head right now. The reason why I'm asking about the Moon is because this area, in particular over here, is important. Because it is the only place you can find Clefairy. That's Alexio. So Ingo is down there. To get down there, we gotta walk a ways. We gotta go a bit of ways. We gotta watch out for the Luxio. Somewhat different from the Electrode I recall. You're a pain in the ass. Busy right now, by the way. Oh, for fuck. hold this idiot. In Ghost Face. I love that expression. The tracks ahead will be perilous, but I pride myself on safe driving. Yeah, well, still kind of keeping mum on him right now. Yes. Mine too, dude, mine too. Either way, there's no need for concern. I know my route and I'll conduct us safely. No darkness nor foul weather will delay us. Onward we roll. Take care to not come uncoupled from me. I recall faintly that I had a partner once, a precious one. Its name escapes me, but I remember that it wielded flames with mastery. If only it were here, I'm sure it would light the way, luring us onward. Please forgive the unscheduled stop. Alpha Crobat. I mean, this is not the most polished game. A man who looks like me. I like winning more than anything else. Well, okay, now that that's come up. Yeah, I see it too. It's, they're kind of, oh my god. And he found the torches. For departure. Follow the track marked by torches, you'll reach the terminus of this cave. And he does his pose again. So, Ingo, Warden of the Pearl Clan. If you have played earlier Pokemon games, you might recognize that name. And some of his appearance. I have not and will not ever forgive Game Freak for this. Ingo! The character from Pokemon Black and White and their sequels. He was once one of two leaders of the Battle Subway. He was the single battle leader. So, the reason why I'm choosing to do Basculin right now is because I need to do certain amounts of recoil damage to Basculin. With what Game Freak did with Ingo is, as Ingo mentioned, god damn it, there was a man who looked like him. Ingo has a younger twin brother named Emmett. Emmett was the master of the double battles in the Battle Subway. I should have gotten more revives too. When Ingo was dragged into Hisui due to the certain circumstances in this game, it left Emmett all alone. This is not the first time Game Freak has taken a Pokemon from where, or a Pokemon trainer. Oh, you were such a baby. Okay, I need that thing to stop looking at me now. The reason why Ingo's kind of got that default done with this kind of situation face is very simply because he and Emmett were. Okay, Volo. Ingo and Emmett were the masks. God damn it, it makes me sad whenever he does that pose. Together, he and Emmett would make po would do that pose. I've lost count of how much recoil damage I've done, but it's not gonna be enough yet. So you if you, even if you played Black and White and Black 2 and White, at least Black and White itself, you would not have seen Ingo and Emmett very easily. God damn it. Nope. Fuck y'all. Black 2 and White 2, you would have seen them, you would have been more likely to see them. Because there was actually a required battle with the two of them. But that is only because the battle subway is the competitive circuit for Black and White. So if you were a casual player, you weren't likely to have caught that. Or you wouldn't have been playing that. Oof. Bronzer wants attention. Splash. Right up. There's something over here. I forget what. Well, I know what it is, I just don't remember where it is exactly. So it's basically it's a like 200 some in recoil damage without fainting. There's another Bronzor. There it is. Get rid of this side up. So, the first time Game Freak did this, it was Salon Maiden Annabelle from no, actually before that it was Looker from Pokemon Platinum in Omega Ruby Alpha Sapphire. And then it was Salon Maiden Annabelle from Emerald. Or, I think that was it. I forget what her actual title was. But it was, she was the leader of the Battle Tower in Emerald. Need those because I'm almost out. Every single time though, the character has lost their memory going through either a space-time rift or just being dragged away from home. Anyway, we're gonna get our fourth ride Pokemon. Because in order to get up there, think she knew some secret, some hidden move. Hidden moves. There are no such things in Hisui, surely. No, but there are in Unova. When it starts snowing. It still makes me so mad. Game Freak, why? I'm gonna be salty this entire damn part. Gliscor is the evolution of Gligar. It is a ground flying type, completely immune to electric types because of its ground typing. However, it is very weak to water. Should also check if Cinder can learn if the move is Infernal Parade that Cinder's got. True to his former employment, Ingo is a very difficult challenge sometimes. Especially later on. I never finished my thought about him and his brother, did I? In black and white, Ingo does not smile. Emmett does. Your talent has brought you to the destination called victory. Emmett and Ingo are kind of a representation of the comedy and tragedy masks. Emmett is comedy, Ingo is tragedy. And there is our finicky girl herself, Sneasler. And she likes me. And we got Toxic Plate. Because Sneasler is a poison fighting type. My final stop. Sneasler is probably one of the better Pokemon you're gonna get. Honestly. Because now you don't have to stop for cliffs. I want to see if there's mischievous around here. Yeah. There's actually a graveyard in this area. So that's probably where I need to go look. But also, another fun part of Sneasler. Now we can get these. She's not very fast. She can climb trees nicely, though. This is the ancient quarry, then yes. So that wisp right there. That one floating right over there. I hate that thing. When I was finishing this the first time, could not find the last wisp in the Coronet Highlands. It was that one that I was missing. Ow. I didn't want to use Basculin either. That was part of why I didn't want to use Basculin for that. Zero. I have like no money left right now. Ugh. That's the one problem I have with this game. You don't earn money from battles. To look at that, because that's gonna bother me if I don't check. Is here. Plant, sandy, and trash. I do have all three cloaks for it. Cool. Still going in the right direction. Sorry, I'm not in the mood. That's not the move. That's also not the Pokemon I needed. What a weirder. And drop. And there we go. Like I said, this is the only area where you can catch. How did I hit that? That was not what I wanted to throw. See me. All right. I caught the Cleffa, so that's important. Just a petal. Yeah, the petals. Alright, cool. I think my dad's going out for bed soon. So, something else is definitely threw that too soon. Where did it go? I think it's gone. Yeah, not a smart idea to jump down. It's, I didn't really want to get spotted by it. I'm on it right now. It's also not the Pokemon I wanted. I wanted you there. Well, that is an alpha golem. Ouch. Daytime now, so this kind of lights is now gonna walk all the way back. We did get the crunchy salt we need, though, for... the, quest. Don't ever really use scatterbangs. Now we're gonna take the other route. Coronet Highlands are probably the best spot for you to grind up iron chunks. Throwing a wing ball because it's a flying type. It makes sense to me. And we got a Razor Fang, which is the item that Gligar needs to level to evolve. Change moves. Yes, we did get Infernal Parade. And I think we'll go with Shadow Ball as well. Infernal Parade is Hisuian Typhlosion's signature move, basically. Like I said, really good place for iron chunks. Is around here because they're just everywhere, basically. Is that satchel? It is. Lost satchel. And now we have a lot of lost satchels even around here. And now, also because we have Sneasler. We can actually get to some of them. And hey, look, there's a Pokemon that may look familiar. It's a Gible. Damn it, it saw me. Eh. It's a lot lower level than I thought it would be. But I got a crit on it, so... That is definitely an alpha bite. Excuse me. Welcome to the Celestica Ruins. Oh, goody, goody, goody gumdrops. What's here is probably one of the only times this is actually gonna hit right. Nose pass. Now, in the Celestica ruins, we have two very familiar figures. Dialga. And Palkia. We go up a little higher. We'll actually be very close to Alpha Luxray. Ouch. Ow. Off. Stupid Alpha Luxray. We're actually very close to where we're supposed to be. Right over there. That is a Hisuian Voltorb. Hisuian Voltorb and Hisuian Electrode are electric grass types. And it's on. This one. They tend to go boom. And I have gotten destroyed by a group who did that before. It's a statue of Pokemon, but it's been broken, and for some reason, it's been left that way. Six feet. Time and space. Down there. This is Giratina. This is a statue for Giratina. And the distortion has activated. Go in there and see how fast we die, basically. Because I'm not confident about this in the slightest. Literally just doing this for the shards right now. That's a tiny artillery, holy crap. Oh, oh, oh. You. I want you though. Ow. You're important. You are a Kranidos. Yo. Mean, I suppose I can't really be surprised it's floating, considering it's a ghost type, but still. It is literally stuck in that tree. already have a Dusclops, so I don't need to catch this one. I just wanted it away from me so I could keep going around here. Both which I can get later because I have their pre-evolutions. But I'm gonna probably need to get another Rim Rage. That is also a Pokemon I want. Shield on! The Pokemon Pearl exclusive of the fossils. Kranidos is the Pokemon Diamond exclusive. That is two Octilleries. I do not want to deal with two Octilleries right now. I'm literally just here to get... Oh my god. My satchel is too full for this nonsense. Organize that. I'm gonna be honest, blue shards are some of the hardest ones to find. Also, apparently it's nighttime now. Two Ambipom and a Dusclops, and one of the Ambipom is being absorbed by the Dusclops. So one thing about this little area, I'll do Basculin because I still need to do some more recoil damage to it. Get the grit dust. Down here normally, there's that thing. That is an Alpha Rhyperior. probably guess it's very mean. I'm not gonna go over to there yet because there's other things I need to do. I don't know how that Pokemon was hiding. So if we head back that way, that's where Melia is gonna be. Let's get rid of this one at least. So once night falls in this area, we can find a Pokemon we are looking for our Abrazu. Being spotted, which is good. There's a Wisp down there, and there's a Mischievous. Yes, you are seeing correctly over there. That is an Alpha Miss Magius. Another Pokemon you can occasionally find in this area. Don't think we're gonna see it. Is a Rotom. In this area, it's pretty much a rarity to see a Rotom. There's another area where you can find them more frequently. Hey, Satchel. Okay, Sneasler. Thank you. We have to wait a little bit for the moon to rise. I'm gonna check and make sure that I have Togetix ready to go. That's 6. Unreported, so move a lot of this stuff into storage. As many of these as I can. Now we have a Togekiss. He'll come up when he's ready, Dad. He'll come up when he's ready. He can. He just doesn't wanna. Oh, there he goes. Good night. Yeah, in case you can't tell, I was trying to get my dad to stop talking into. Oh, there's the moon. I was looking at the wrong side. It's all my fault. So every 2 times you sleep until nightfall, the moon will change. is what I was waiting for. Go to Sneasler. Send. Basket Legion. The reason I wanted to wait for the full moon is because I'm going the wrong way. No, I'm not. I'm still going the correct route. Sneasler, come on. Actually, I don't think I can do this yet. Now that I think about it, I think I have to actually have the quest active for it. We're gonna head back to the Highlands camp real quick, and we're gonna go talk to the professor. Yep, I did complete Togetic. So I can't do the side quest that I want to get yet because it's not available until after I've finished up over here. So now we can do different hairstyles and different colors. We have the the Team Galactic haircut. This one in particular is actually pretty nice. Now we have some nicer colors. I can turn my hair purple if I wanted to. I think I will for a bit. Let's actually turn my across. Nope, that's too bright. It won't show. And Zeke. Because one, they got lost again. Don't want to give up my nose pass yet, because that's my nose pass. Can't even make this yet. And he has the leaden wing balls for sale. And we have full heals. For a little bit. I don't have enough money right now. 46. What level is Cinder right now? 43. Not high enough. You're gonna keep going and try to catch more Pokemon and earn some more money. Oh, good. Perfect. We'll go try and catch some Krogunk. Also, because we now have Sneasler. We can climb up here. And get this finally. Alpha Raichu, no thank you. Ooh, we got a Firestone out of that too. Very nice. Closer. Let's try. Never mind. That's a nice catch, though. Thank you. again, now that we have Sneasler, we can go up on higher ledges. Sees me. We're at 28. Well, Pokemon, 11 of which were Krogunk. A lot more money than I thought I did. Also, I should go over here. No, the mint harvest is for, of course, they're for mints. Mints are for switching around certain stats. So, we've got some interesting things now from Ginter. A mechanical tub and a mechanical circular saw. Can't afford the next one because it goes up in price every time. Which is going to require a lot. The mechanical tub is a washing machine, but using it would. I didn't know it said that. So, as you can probably guess, there are Rotom in this game. So yes, the items to evolve or evolve to change Rotom's forms are also here. Linking cord is required for four Pokemon. Specifically a female one that I can evolve. I don't think so. I think I only have three. Single Burmy. Don't have a trash form Burmy. What? Thought I'd caught all three forms. Hold up. No, I have not caught trash form. Cloak Burmy is in the coastlands. I'm in box three. The only one here is the sand cloak. I don't have trash cloak. There's three different Burmese: leaf, sand, and trash. I apparently have caught a trash cloak, I just don't know where it is right now. Oh, there it is. Thank you. Well, I still need to catch another one because I don't want to lose any of these, so. Make sure I get a f catch another female one. Don't know why I went over here instead of over here. Ugh. So I just want to show one thing. There's one all the way at the top of this. Whoa, that was a power pointy Golbat right then. That's probably a Burmy. Was a Burmy. Is it a female Burmy now? Nope. So after Fire Spit Island, the Misfortune Sisters will be hiding around the map. And if they see you or you see them, they will fight you. You're using a Pokemon that has a quad weakness to fire against a trainer who's using a fire type, you idiot. And they'll disappear every time. And you can get items from them. Beaver thought me right in my face there. That's another Alpha Beaverell. Interesting. So for one thing, when I was searching for Cherubi, I was looking in the wrong spot. Cannot find Cherubi out in this area. It is only found down in this area. Now we can climb up here and see what's around. Including but not limited to a Machop that I need to catch because I need another one. So right now we are above the Obsidian Falls area. have to be careful because there is an alpha up here. So, if we are extremely... careful, we might... There's PowerPoint Gyarados. There's the alpha. It's an alpha blissy. If it weren't for the fact that it had to be a female Burmese, I would have caught that one, but it does have to be a female. Male Burmese evolve into Mothim. Yeah, that or I'd have to actually find a Wormadam, which is pretty rare. Yep. So used to pushing the left stick into boost because I've been playing Pokemon Violet a lot lately, and in order to make Miraidon run go faster, you have to use the left stick. And I want to fight Nishinx because Shanks is not a good opponent. Jude would be, though. So, the reason why I'm constantly checking Basculin is because, again, after a certain point of recoil, Basculin... Basculin evolves after it's taken a certain amount of recoil damage. That's a lot bigger of an Alpha Beaverell. That was a lot of damage. Still no. Points of recoil damage is what I need to get my Basculin to evolve. I have no idea where I'm at right now. In. I don't know. I don't remember. I don't think, as long as it's not from. From the recoil, I think. Has to stay conscious. It does reset when you faint, when it faints. That explains why I'm having so much problems. Okay, finally. That sucks. You can heal, you just can't let Basculin faint at all. Yep, you actually want to fight me. Go back to that in a minute. 6 star. Over halfway through. Ultra Balls. Max Potions. Shortcut. Nice. Actually, the Heights Camp was probably not the best answer. Because if I have to guess. Oh no, it was. It was right here. Face that Alpha Geodude. Ready to evolve. And now we have our own Basculegion. Yeah, if I do that. Actually, do I have? switch to blood. Stayed a little longer because I started started stream so late, so Sunday we will be continuing. We will see if we can do the Electrode fight, otherwise I'm just gonna be off screen. I'm gonna be catching a lot of Pokemon so that I can have so I can get some more money. I'm pretty much just gonna be catching Pokemon. But yeah. We are gonna head back to Jubilee. So, I only have a male Vasculation right now. Vasculation clads itself in the souls of its comrades that perished before fulfilling their goals of journeying upstream. It's basically a very angry Pokemon. One more thing I gotta do. I wanna get this quest done before I go to bed. Now we can get EXP Candy L's as well. We got the jack, we got the snow stuff. Nice. also, we got the Sneasler, Fancy Bottoms. The reason I don't advise doing that is because it's a lot. Oh, right, that's what that is. I should probably change my hair color again then. Because you can just get the. If you can get the shards in the space time distortions, you can make the. Star pieces. I just want to change my color because you can't see my headband. Now I can see my headband better. Anyway, again, Sunday we will keep going. Potentially finish off. The electrode fight. Start the next. Maybe start the last area. Again, off screen, I will probably be just. Catching Pokemon like mad. So I will see you on Sunday. Bye.